Hello, welcome to Staggernots. I'm super excited about today. I'm super glad that you're watching. You're watching, right? You're watching. Well, if you weren't watching, you wouldn't be listening to me, so I presume you're watching. That would make... Anyway, welcome to Staggernots. I'm super excited that you are watching today. Before we get started, as always, just like when you come to Staggernots in person, there's a couple rules, right? So let's go over those rules. Really simple, really easy. There's like three of them. Have fun. If you're not having fun, then you're breaking your rules. So you better be having fun, okay? Like, you better be having fun, right? That's just how it goes. And as I say sometimes, if you go through the entire program and it was boring, like not even one part of it was fun, then what I want you to do is I want you to write down some ideas that you think would make it be more fun, send them to me, or hey, if you want to, you know, just tell them to me, go ahead and tell them to me. We have an email, IGotQuestions@staggernots.com. Send it in there and say, hey, you know, well, of course that's got questions, not, you know, answers, but I'll allow it to say, hey, this would make your program like that much better, or it would make it even good to begin with, you know, if you're totally bored. So, because it wouldn't be fair for me to make it a rule to have fun and it's totally boring, right? That wouldn't be fair. So have fun. It's a rule. If you've got suggestions that would make it better, send them our way. That's a rule. Well, it's not a rule. You have to send suggestions. It's a rule to have fun. You know all this. Anyway, second rule, listen to the teacher. That's me. Listen to what I'm saying because it's super important and it'll really help you in life in a lot of awesome ways. And so, yeah, just listen to me. And rule number three is no helping others break the rules. So if you're making it so someone else can't listen to what I'm saying, or if you're making someone else bored or angry while they're trying to watch, you're breaking a rule. All right. Now, usually if you come to Staggernots in person, you get a clothespin for being here, right? You get clothespin for being here, for bringing your Bible, and for answering questions and things like that, but this is online, so that didn't quite, we can't really give you a clothespin, right? And clothespin, of course, you can turn in for candy at the end of class. Well, here's how this is going to work, okay? If you watch this program, you can get a clothespin next time you come in, but I'm going to need some proof that you watched the entire program just to make sure that I can really give you the clothespin. So here's what's going to happen. Throughout the program, I'm going to say a secret word, okay? I'll say, all right, here's the secret word, and then here's the next secret word. You need to get a pencil and a paper out, and you need to write down that secret word, okay? Because by the end of the program, there's going to be six of them, and I'm not going to tell you where they are, but it's going to make a phrase, all right? There are six secret words. It's going to make a phrase. You need to write that phrase down, and next time you come in, You bring that to me, that written thing, and said, here's what the secret word was, and you'll get a clothespin for being here. All right, does that sound like fun? I hope it does, because it's kind of supposed to be fun. So with that, well, I may say it, or it may show up on the screen somewhere, just going to say that, and it'll say secret word, and it'll be written down there, write it down. So just keep an eye out. Maybe I'll say it. Maybe it'll be written somewhere. So you better be paying really close attention, okay? With that, I want you to stand on up where you're watching. If you're watching from somewhere where you can stand up, sing along with this song, do the motions. If you can't stand up because you're like in a car somewhere or something like that, you should stand up in a car. It's really not safe. So stay sitting down, but sing as long as it doesn't distract the driver. You know, do the motions, and hey, get ready to praise the Lord. Mountain, it's in your way. You want to move it, it wants to stay. You need the power that comes from F-A-I-T-H. With dark and sickness, or poverty, and pockets, and the problem has got to flee. It's the power that comes from F-A-I-T-H. A-I-T-H. Just give me an F.
F.
A.
A.
I.
I.
T.
H.
Say F.
F.
A.
A.
I.
I.
T. H. We're talking power that comes from F. A. I. T. H. It will always work for you. The blood of Jesus guarantees it's true. It's the power that comes from F-A-I-T-H. Give me an F.
A-I-T-H.
Say F.
A-I-T-H.
We're talking power that comes from F-A-I-T-H. You've got a mountain, it's in your way. You want to move it, it wants to stay. You need the power that comes from F-A-I-T-H. Give me an F.
A-I-T-H.
Say F.
A-I-T-H.
We're talking power that comes from F-A-I-T-H. Hey, what do you say? Move that mountain out of the way. It's the power that comes from F-A-I-T-H. Hey, what do you say? Move that mountain out of the way. Power we're talking about. F-A-I-T-H. Hey, what do you say? Move that mountain out of the way. It's the power that comes from F-A-I-T-H. Today, we're talking about seeds, all right? We're talking about seeds, and we have a memory verse for today. So I'm going to turn to that memory verse. In fact, I'm going to do a sword drill. If you've got a Bible with you where you're watching this, then, hey, you can do a sword drill with me here. So we're going to see how fast I can turn to the memory verse today, all right? And here's what it is, all right? Sword drill works. You got to put your Bible on your palm like this, keep it flat. There's no, you know, no pinkies, no thumbs, trying to give you a head start on turning. That's just not fair. So we're not doing that. You keep your palm flat. You put it here. You keep your other hand at your side. And as soon as I say go, you can turn to it. So I'm going to do it. If you have a Bible with you while you're watching this, do it too. All right, here you go. The memory verse for today, you got to wait till I say go. It's Galatians 6:7. I didn't say go. Don't, come on. Put it back up on your palm, put it flat, there you go. Maybe you didn't turn, but, you know, hey, sometimes it happens, so, alright, anyway, I'm just messing with you. Here we go. Galatians 6:7, go! Ha! Got it. Yeah. I've had a lot of practice, so, yeah, I can do it kind of fast. Anyway, here's what it says. It says, be not deceived. That means to be tricked or, you know, thinking something's, you know, wrong in your own mind. It says, be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. Now, the word sow refers to seeds. When you plant a seed into the ground, it's called sowing. And what happens when you plant a seed? It comes up, right? Whatever you planted, it's going to come up and produce after its own kind. And we're going to talk more about that as we go on here. By the way, the first secret word of today's program is so. It's S-O-W. So. It's on the screen there. You can look at it how it's spelled there. First secret word is so. So just keep that in mind. Ha! So. Keep that in. Never mind. Galatians 6:7 says, whatever you sow, you will reap. Whatever a man sows, that will he also reap. Okay? So everything you do, it's like planting a seed into the ground. And just like that seed brings up its own kind, it's everything you do produces after its own kind, and it comes back to you. We're going to talk a little bit more as we go on. For now, I want you to watch this special program. Now, these are clips from a very special show. It's like my favorite show in like the world to watch. Well, it's like, it's pretty close up there. I mean, I grew up on it. It's an awesome show, but I've simplified a plot here that I want you to watch because it's going to talk about what we're talking about today. That's a lot of words, but okay. And it's about sowing a seed. There are a couple of pranksters who are bored.
This is the slowest moving town I ever seen. Nothing exciting ever happens here. There ain't nothing to do. What we need is a good idea for a prank.
What we need's a good idea for a prank.
That's what we need. Oh, Elmer. Look at this. Look. Huh?
Yeah. You want us to lose our hair so we can make people laugh. I don't think I want to do that.
Not us. We'll order some of this stuff and put it in the hair tonic bottle at Lefty Barbershop.
Something kind of mean to their friend Lefty. I don't know if you caught all of it, but the guy in the pink shirt, his name is Nicodemus. The guy in the gray shirt, his name is Elmer Barnes. And they have a friend who owns a barbershop. His name is Lefty. And they have a plan to do something really mean, right? They're going to replace his hair tonic that he puts to make your hair look nice when you're gotten a haircut, and replace it with hair remover so that people will go bald. That's really mean, isn't it? That's really mean. Well, we'll just see how bad that is as we go along here, okay? Now, the next secret word, by the way, just showed up on the screen there. It's the second secret word. Remember, there's six of them. We had one in the beginning, and this is the second one right there. So you got to be looking for that here. It's right next to me. Or is it over here? You know where it is. You can see it. So write that down. That's your first two words in a phrase, and if you get the whole phrase and you bring it in, you get a clothespin because you watched this whole program, okay? So, there's the second secret word, and with that, we're going to talk a little bit about seeds. Alright, so everything that you do is like a seed, right? I have an example here of some seeds, all right? These, I don't know how well you can see what type of seed it is here on the program here, but these are pumpkin seeds, all right? And they're very, very interesting. These are actually salted pumpkin seeds. They're kind of made for eating. I wouldn't really eat them at this point. They're kind of old. They've kind of been sitting around for a little bit here. But this is a pumpkin seed, and it reminds me of an actual true story that happened to me when I was younger. When I was younger, somewhere about the ages of 10 to 12, somewhere in that range, we lived in the state of Missouri. My family and I, we lived in the state of Missouri. And it was fall time, and we had gotten some pumpkins. And after a while, everything that all fruit, it sits out for a while, begins to rot, right? And we had a front door, and there was a little walkway, and it kind of went to our driveway near our garage, and in between that little walled-off area was a little patch of mulch. Well, I got an idea one day, and I feel like it was kind of fresh in my mind about seeds, and so I took one of the pumpkin seeds out of the pumpkins that we had had that had been decaying, and it was kind of cool to look at the pumpkin seeds. It was much more interesting to look at them then than in a box like this. It was more fun to see it in a running pumpkin. But anyway, that's not important. I took one of those seeds, I took a little bit of the mulch away, you know, threw it down in there, covered it over, and walked away and completely forgot about it. Well, some time went by, and I don't remember how long it was, but some time went by, and this vine started growing out of the ground. What do you think that was? It was a pumpkin vine. And it grows, is fine, and the flower grows out of it, and then out of that flower comes a pumpkin. And it became very hard to deal with because it grew several pumpkins, and we had pumpkin after pumpkin, and the vine grew kind of out into our walkway. We had to trim it back, and I don't remember how long it lasted, but it grew a bunch of pumpkins, and that's because I planted a pumpkin seed into the ground, and it grows after its own kind. And everything you do is just like that, okay? Everything you do is a seed. If you're kind to people, if you're mean to people, it's a seed. And just like that pumpkin seed grew, and it grew a pumpkin. And here's the thing about a pumpkin doesn't have just one seed in it. It has multiple seeds. And from that one pumpkin seed, or maybe there's a few in there, but it was that one vine, it grew several pumpkins that had several seeds. And so it made it easier to sow more pumpkins, to plant more pumpkins. And everything you do is also like that. When you sow a seed, if you're mean to someone, well, you're going to get meanness back to you. People are going to be mean to you because you are mean to other people. And all of a sudden, you get more seeds in yourself to be mean again. And then it just keeps coming back, and it's not good. So what you got to do is you got to stop being mean to people. Start being nice to people. In fact, there is a scripture that says this. If you ever heard of the golden rule, it's a common phrase people use, and they talk about being kind to people, and it actually is in the Bible. It's something Jesus said. So if you didn't know that, it's in Matthew 7:12, and it says that whatever you would want men to do to you, and I'm summarizing what it says, but whatever you'd want men to do to you, do to them. Okay? And that's what people call the golden rule. It's actually something Jesus said. So if someone, you know, says, hey, remember the golden rule, you can say, yes, Jesus said it. And you can tell them where it's found even. And it's kind of cool to know that. But the point of that is that if you want it to happen to you, you need to do it to others first because you planted a seed. And that seed will come back to you, and it comes more. You know, when I planted that seed, I got tons more seeds than I planted. You get more back and able to plant more. And so you get a whole lot more back than what you put in there. And so it's important to sow the right kinds of seeds in your life. By the way, the third secret word of the program today is seed. All right, we've had three so far. All right, and so if you got those first two, you need to write it down, because if you write it down and you bring in to me the full phrase, it's six words. If you bring that full phrase in, you'll get a clothespin for watching the program, okay? So you might want to do that. You might want to do that. Might be pretty cool. You may see why. So that third word is seed. If you got the other two, you got that. If you didn't, go back and look for it and then come back. And but still, I want you to watch the full program. Don't cheat and look for secret words. I mean, that would not be nice, right? All right, so now we get the three of the six secret words, and with that, we kind of want to visit our pranksters again, all right? They had made a plan, all right, to do something mean, just to be funny. They wanted to do something mean to their friend, Lefty. So let's see what has happened now. They decided to order some hair remover, and let's see what happens next.
What do we do now?
Well, I figure we gotta get Lefty out of the shop long enough to replace his hair tonic with this stuff.
I got an idea.
What's that, Willie?
Well, got an idea.
You did? good.
Thanks, Elmer. That was great.
Well, here, Lefty. Have another cup.
No, I can't. I've got to get back to the shop. I've got an appointment with Jasper Marlowe.
Oh, Jasper Marlowe.
Yeah.
Hey, yeah, I know old Jasper Marlowe.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's a good old boy. Well, okay, Lefty, okay.
Hey, thanks for the lemonade. I owe you one.
Okay. Nicodemus, I think you better come out here.
Did he have a customer?
Lefty gave him a good dose of you know what. Ooh, sorry.
Boys, what are you up to?
Nothing really. We're just having a little fun, Marshal. Go on.
Go spill the beans about our prank.
Can't help it, it's funny. Pour that tonic all over Jasper's head. The stuff is already working.
Yeah.
You should have seen the hair in the coat.
I wonder who's going to be the next ball in his hands. I got. That's so funny.
All right, you two. What's so funny?
Well, we can't tell you.
Lefty would kill us.
Are you two boys playing a practical joke on Lefty?
Who, us? We wouldn't do anything to Lefty.
Better be careful. You reap what you sow.
Ooh, now there's a scary thought. We could both wind up bald.
No.
I want to say that the next secret word showed up on the screen. That's secret word number 4, right? Yes, 4. Alright, so you might want to write that down, because it's going to help you get a clothespin. So you might want to write that down.
I'm Lemmy the Lemon, and I've got a Bible verse for you from Galatians 6:7, and it says, "Be not deceived, for God is not mocked. Whatever a man sows, that he shall also reap." Yeah. See you next time.
Praise Him, praise Him, praise Him in the morning, praise Him in the noontime, praise Him, praise Him, praise Him when the sun goes down, praise Him, praise Him, praise Him in the morning, praise Him in the noontime, praise Him, praise Him. Praise Him when the sun goes down. Love Him, love Him, love Him in the morning, love Him in the noontime. Love Him, love Him, love Him when the sun goes down. I love Him better every D-A-Y. I love Him better every D-A-Y. Close by Him, that's I-D-E-I, Willie, I-D-E-I, love Him better every day. Praise Him, praise Him, praise Him in the morning, praise Him in the noontime. Praise Him, praise Him, praise Him when the sun goes down. I love Him better every D-A-Y. I love Him better every D-A-Y. Close by is S-I-D-E-I, will it be I-D-E-I, love Him better every day. Love Him, love him. Love him in the morning, love him in the noontime. Love him, love him. Love him when the sun goes down. Praise him, praise him. Praise him in the morning, praise him in the noontime. Praise him, praise him. Praise him when the sun goes down. Praise him when the sun goes down.
So today's memory verse is Galatians 6:7. It says, do not be deceived, God is not mocked. Whatever a man sows, that will he also reap. That means anything you sow, it comes back to you. Anything you plant, right? Just like any type of seed, right? It comes up, it produces after its own kind. A pumpkin seed will grow pumpkins, a watermelon seed will grow watermelons, and I mean banana seed, other banana seeds. An apple seed, you know, a cherry pit will grow a cherry tree, right? And all those different things, and they grow after their own kind, right? Well, is that just limited to food, do you think? Is that limited to food where only you plant, you know, seed, like food seeds, like fruit seeds? Well, the Bible says whatever a man sows, and there are all other types of things you can do as a seed. You see, everything you do is actually a seed, okay? And this balloon, we're going to say represents, it's got inside of it what I would call, you know, something like seed, okay? It's playing the role of seed in this object lesson here. And this is like the ground, okay? Here, it's got a little something in there that maybe I'll explain what it is afterward. You may have seen this experiment before, but I want you to watch and listen anyway. And so the Bible says that whatever a man sows, he's going to reap, okay? That's anything you do. You know, that can be the way you treat people. If you're mean to people, that's a seed. If you're nice to people, that's also a seed. If you quickly lose patience with people, well, that's a seed. I mean, if you give your time to someone, they need help with something, and you give your time, that's a seed. If you give someone money, that's a seed. If you have something that you know someone would like, and you decide to give it to them, that's a seed, and everything you do is a seed, okay? And it's like planting it in the ground here, and we're going to watch what happens when we put seed into the ground here, okay? Uh-oh, my balloon just popped, sort of. It just snapped. We're going to have to be very, very careful with this balloon, okay? All right, going to hold on tight here. Now, whenever you do something, whatever it is, it's the way you treat people, if you show up on time, if you're mean, if you give someone something, you do something for someone, those are all seeds. And just like the Bible says, whatever you sow, you reap, okay? It's like this balloon here. It has a seed in it, and something is happening to that seed here. It's growing, right? It's producing something. Boy, it's producing a lot, too, here. Wow. It's getting nice and big. Almost kind of nervous. Hope it doesn't pop. My face is kind of close to this thing, you know? I should be fine. Alright, so I got a little bit more seed in there. Get that seed out in there. Alright. Oh boy, now it really feels like it's going to pop. Don't pop. Okay, so, well, I make sure this doesn't pop. What happened was, there was a seed in here, right? And that seed went into the ground, and it brought out a harvest, right? It brought something up here. Let's see if I can pull this off here. All right. Wait for it. Oof, get a little powder there. All right, it grew a harvest here, all right? It grew out a nice little balloon, and it's all on its own. It can sustain itself on its own here. There we go. All right, it's a nice tied-off balloon. And everything you do is like that. Everything you do is a seed that you plant into the ground. And just like this balloon, when that seed went into the, what it is it's baking soda and vinegar, and when you put baking soda into vinegar, it creates a gas that starts filling up the balloon here, all right? But everything you do is a seed, and it fills up whatever you do, and it comes back to you just exactly what you do. Like I said, if you're wondering, why are people mean to me all the time? Well, you may have sown a seed of being mean to someone. Start sowing seeds of kindness, being kind to people. And some people are just mean in general, and they just like to be mean. But you may have sown a seed for it. And if you sow seeds of kindness, the Bible says that, you know, what you want others to do to you, it says it in Matthew 7:12, if I got that reference right, says do what you would have other people do to you, do to them first. Because, and he said this is like the entire law that God gave his people. It's summed up in that. But because everything you do is a seed, and it comes back to you. Just like this, you know, was filled up with this gas here, and it's still fizzing. I don't know how well you can see there, but it's still bubbling. It's not soda. I would not drink it. It's vinegar and baking soda. Don't drink it. That's really gross. But anyway, it grows after its own kind. So like our member verse says, whatever a man sows, that shall he also reap, okay? Whatever you sow comes back to you, anything you do. So it's important to be careful with what you sow and how you treat people and what you do, because it always, always comes back to you. All right, so with that, we're almost ready to see the conclusion of the story. But as you can tell, something's on the screen there. The fifth secret word. Remember, if you get all six secret words written down in the phrase, right, you get a clothespin. So you might want to write that word. It's on this side. Okay, it's on this side. Whatever. You saw that. But it's over here, and you might want to write that down because there's only one word left. All right, and if you've got that word, then you, excuse me, if you've got that phrase, then you'll get a clothespin for watching the program, because you proved that you watched enough of it to see it, all right? And yes, it's the same as an earlier word, but you need to have both, okay? So you need to have both in there to understand it. I just even gave you that much of a hint, but that's okay. All right, so we're going to watch the conclusion. Remember, our pranksters, what has happened so far, right? They planned to do something mean to Lefty, and now they went ahead and done it. And what have they done? They've sown a seed. That's a that lady who was walking from the store while they're, you know, walking downtown laughing, her name is Miss Lana, and she told him, you better be careful because you reap what you sow. And they said, ooh, that's a scary thought, and I'm not going to remind you all what they said there, but you can go back and look at it again. But before we get into that, I have a special guest here, and it's kind of not totally about the program today, but he's a special friend of mine. He's a very special friend of mine. His name is Ryan Simon. And we're going to release, once this program has gone out onto YouTube, this particular video will be on the channel. So what I'm doing is I'm premiering that video in today's program. And when we watch this song with Ryan Simon, we're going to see what happens to the pranksters for sowing seeds of baldness. All right, so here's a video that you'll be able to find on our YouTube channel after this with our friend Ryan Simon singing a super awesome song, and then we'll see what happens to our pranksters.
You mentioned a Memphis sounding horn section. I hear a baritone sax. There's a tenor. Anyway, whatever. Something deep on top of this. I mean, you can almost go into a little rock and roll. It's kind of a 50s thing, but not quite.
Yep. Listen up now, y'all. I'm gonna try and reach you. Class is now in session. Pay attention to the teacher. We're going through the book, Genesis to Revelation. I'll teach your head how to spread salvation to the nation. We'll start off with the basics, a checklist for the saints. Love the Lord with all your heart and mind and soul and strength. To fear the Lord is wisdom, to serve the Lord divine. But to really break it down, just repeat these words of mine.
Say, I love Jesus.
I love Jesus.
Yes, I do.
Paper. The lesson now begins. First up, church artillery. We are at war with sin. God trains us to evangelists, apostles, prophets too. Pastors, teachers, five and all. We got work to do. Discernment, tongues, interpretation, prophecy, and faith. Wisdom, knowledge, healing, miracles. Yeah, those are great. These gifts are like atomic bombs. They make the word explode. But they just don't mean nothing unless you know the code.
That code is I love Jesus.
Yes, I do.
Haircut there, Jasper.
It's very becoming of you, Jasper.
Just wait till I get my hands on Lefty.
Uh-oh.
What's going on?
What happened to your hair?
You tell me. It fell out last night at the Opera House. You made a fool out of me.
I didn't do nothing.
Whatever you put on my hair caused it to fall out.
I've never seen Jasper so mad.
And Lefty's pale as a ghost.
Excuse me, boys. You're about to witness a beating.
Leave me alone. Both of you, leave me alone.
All right, you boys got a problem?
Get out of here, deputy. This isn't anything we can't handle.
He put hair remover on my head. Look at me.
I don't know what happened, Nicodemus. I just use the stuff I always use. Whatever it was, it caused my hair to fall out.
Well, now, just maybe it wasn't Lefty's fault. You ever think about that, Jasper?
What do you mean?
Well, maybe somebody came in here and switched the hair tonic for hair remover. And maybe that somebody wasn't even Lefty.
Well, yeah, he could have been anybody, even us.
Wait a minute. It was you.
Me?
Yes, you lured me out of the shop with your lemonade. And you put hair remover in my tonic. This is hair remover.
Grab them, boys. I think we can use some of the lamp tonic we use.
Nicodemus, what happened to your hair?
My hair? Oh, it's just short. Nothing. I'm reaping what I sowed. I'll explain later.
You, reap what you sowed?
I reckon I had it coming.
All right, so if you didn't catch it, this final secret word appeared on the screen during that segment of the final thing that happened to the prankster. So if you missed that, go back and find it there so you can get that. And that's the final word. That's all six words. I'm not going to say the phrase as one sentence because you could just skip forward to where I say it and that'd be cheating, right? But if you got it all written down, bring that piece of paper next time you come into Staggernots. You can hand that to me and you'll get a clothespin for watching the program, all right? But
A disclaimer.
Okay, so I hope you got it all down today, and what we tried to learn here was very, very important. Our memory verse, be not deceived, God is not mocked. Whatever a man sows, that shall he also reap. And that's anything and everything you do. If that's giving money, if that's giving time, if that's being mean or being kind, if that is, I mean, it's anything you do. If you plant a seed into the ground like an apple seed, it'll happen. Like, hey, like I said earlier, the pumpkin seed, right? I planted a pumpkin seed into the mulch and I got a lot of pumpkins out of it, right? There you go. And so everything you do is a seed, so it's important to be careful what seeds you sow because it comes back to you. So I hope that you learned that and that you got the memory verse and that you know to be careful how you treat people and the things that you do. And hey, if you want to see it in action, sow a seed, you know, do something. Take time to be kind to someone. Go out of your way to show someone extra kindness. And watch the seed bring a harvest in your life of people being kind to you. You see someone that's sad, take a moment and try to help them, encourage them, and you know, give them an opportunity to laugh and make their day just a little bit nicer and make them happier. And watch next time you're kind of feeling sad, someone's going to do the same to you, because what you sow, you reap. What you do to others will be done to you. So I'm super glad that you came and joined us for Staggernots today. Like I said, if you got that secret phrase down, you will get a clothespin for coming in, all right? And I hope that you enjoyed that little program. That show is called Bill Gunter, U.S. Marshal. It's one of my favorite shows, and just kind of put it out there for you to see what happens when you sow a seed. You get a harvest. They sow the seed for baldness, and they wound up bald. And, I mean, it doesn't seem like a big thing when it's baldness, but however, any seed, no matter what it is, it comes back to you. So, yeah, with that, I guess I'll have to say we'll see you next time.
New creation, 'cause I have a new relation. I am a new creation in Jesus Christ.